Bouncer and the Spring Hoppers. This is a character-building story about responsibility. And one thing we learn about responsibility is, it's doing what others rely on you to do. It was another beautiful day in Agape Land. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, and all the little animals were out having fun. All except Bouncer, that is.
Bouncer, don't forget to put away all your toys, said Mama Rabbit. And you need to make your bed and finish cleaning up your room.
Before the little rabbit could even say anything, she continued,
Remember, Stevie's coming over and you want all your work done.
Can I do it later? Asked Bouncer.
Well, Bouncer, remember what you've been learning about responsibility.
Oh, yeah, he said.
Bouncer had been hearing a lot about responsibility lately, but it seemed hard for him to remember. He even wondered if it was all that important. But he did what his mother asked him to anyway, and he was finished by the time Stevie arrived.
Whee! This is fun! Squealed Bouncer as he did a double flip in the air.
You're really good at bouncing, said Stevie. I'm amazed at the tricks you can do with my pair of spring hoppers.
Thanks for bringing them over, Stevie. This is the greatest toy ever.
And it was. At least all their friends thought so. Spring hoppers were the most popular toy of the season. They looked just like ordinary tennis shoes, but were quite different. It was a secret formula that made them so special. With spring hoppers, you could run faster, jump further, and bounce higher. It felt like you were wearing your own little pair of trampolines. A little later that afternoon, Stevie said,
I have to go home now, Bouncer, but if you want, I could leave the spring hoppers here for you to play with while I'm gone.
Oh, great, said Bouncer. That would be a lot of fun.
Okay, I'll pick them up tomorrow, said Stevie. Just one thing, remember not to get the spring hoppers wet. Water ruins the special formula, and then they'll be just like ordinary tennis shoes.
I'll remember, Stevie, said Bouncer. I promise to take care of them. There's nothing to worry about.
Goodbye, said Stevie as he ran off towards home.
Bouncer was so excited. He could already bounce pretty high, but on the spring hoppers, he felt like he could jump high enough to touch the treetops. He was about to try a triple flip when he heard his mother call,
Bouncer, I'm going to the store for a while, and it looks like it's going to rain soon, so put your juggling balls and scooter inside, and especially Stevie's spring hoppers. You know what happens if they get wet, and he trusted you to be responsible.
And with that, she began to sing a song.
Responsibility, it means your trust in me to do a job the way it should be done. Responsibility, if taken seriously, responsible is what you will become. When you sit down to supper, there would be no bread to eat. Responsibility, it means your trust in me to do a job the way it should be done. If the rooster didn't do his job and sing his wake-up song, folks would still be sleeping, they'd be snoring all day long. Responsibility, if taken seriously, responsible is what you will become.
Now remember, don't just hop around and forget your responsibility, Mama Rabbit reminded.
She waved, tucked her umbrella under her arm, and down the path she went. Bouncer took off the spring hoppers and laid them on the ground in the corner of the yard. He went over to his scooter.
I guess I could put this away first. Vroom, vroom, he shouted.
He sped his scooter around and around.
The incredible Bouncer is in first place. He's coming to the finish line, and he's... Yes, yes, Bouncer's the winner!
He rode his scooter around the yard a few more times, then he rode it into the shed. Meanwhile, the clouds were growing darker, and the wind was beginning to whistle in the trees. But Bouncer didn't notice. He was having too much fun. As he came out of the shed, he stumbled on one of his juggling balls.
Oh, yeah, Bouncer remembered. I'm supposed to pick up my toys and put them in the house before it starts to rain.
He scooped up the juggling balls and took them into the house. He couldn't resist the fun of juggling the balls. He loved to make believe he was a clown in the circus. He could almost hear the music of the band. He could even hear the ringmaster introducing him.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bouncer the Amazing Juggling Clown!
Bouncer imagined the spotlight was on him in the center ring. A hush fell over the crowd as he hurled the balls high over his head and then made them circle around and around and around. The audience cheered and then burst into applause. But it wasn't really applause at all. It was the rain falling on the roof. The balls flew everywhere as he hopped over to the window to look outside. He saw the heavy rain coming down.
Oh, no, cried Bouncer. Stevie's spring hoppers, they're all wet, and I was responsible for them.
He dashed out into the rain to get the spring hoppers, but it was too late. They were ruined. Bouncer sat down and watched the rain trickling down the window pane. A little while later, Bouncer's mom returned from the store.
I'm home, she said brightly.
She shook the droplets of rain from her umbrella.
And I brought you a surprise. I know how much you liked bouncing on Stevie's spring hoppers, so I brought you a pair.
His mother was setting her shopping bags down when Bouncer cleared his throat and said,
Mama, I need to talk to you.
She could tell something was wrong. Bouncer's ears were drooping and a tear was rolling down his cheek.
What's the matter, Bouncer?
Bouncer told her what had happened. He told her about how he forgot to bring the spring hoppers inside and that the rain had ruined them.
What am I going to tell Stevie, he said. Oh, if only I'd been more responsible.
Bouncer crawled up on his bed. He was very sad. He sat thinking about what he had done when all of a sudden his big ears popped up.
I have an idea, he said excitedly. How about if I tell Stevie exactly what happened and then give him the spring hoppers you brought for me? Bouncer, I think that's a wonderful idea.
His mother smiled proudly.
Now I know you're learning to be responsible.
The next day the doorbell rang.
I wonder if that's Stevie, said Bouncer as he pulled open the door.
It was.
Am I glad to see you, Bouncer said. Come on in.
He told Stevie the whole story and apologized for not being responsible. Then he handed Stevie the new spring hoppers. Stevie looked at the little rabbit.
Thank you, Bouncer. And now I have something for you.
Then, with a twinkle in his eye, Stevie pulled something out of a bag he was carrying. It was a pair of brand new spring hoppers.
I knew how much you liked them, so I got you a pair. Would you like to go outside and play with them? Of course I would, shouted Bouncer.
And for the rest of the day, the two friends played and played and played.